Kill our souls. My governor, Greg Abbott, he's kicking butt and taking names. Following a huge court defeat for President Obama's executive action on immigration earlier this week, Governor Abbott has warned the president that using an executive order to protect 5 million illegal aliens from deportation, that's illegal. And the president is now reportedly appealing to this ruling to the Supreme Court. Governor Abbott would like to remind President Obama of his own words. Watch.
The on-camera statements by Barack Obama himself.
On 22 other occasions, he said he did not have the legal authority to do this.
I wish that I could just bypass Congress and change the law myself. But that's not how democracy works. That's not how democracy works.
That's not how our democracy functions.
I'm the President of the United States. I'm not the Emperor of the United States.
Believe me, the idea of doing things on my own is very tempting.
The notion that I can just suspend deportations through executive order, that's just not the case.
There's some things we can't do. There's a limit to what I can do.
I'm required to follow the law. Then essentially I would be ignoring the law.
The American people are not going to tolerate it anymore. The rule of law still applies even to the President of the United States of America.
Texas Governor Greg Abbott joins me now. Good to have you again, sir. Always good to talk with you. This ad that supports you, that is supportive of your stance as well, supportive of the stance of following the law and upholding the law. I mean, the president has said, you know, he's not a dictator. He can't just wave a wand and handle deportations and handle immigration law. But yet that is exactly what he's doing here and trying to usurp your authority as governor of Texas.
Danny, this is exactly why the American people are so frustrated about what's going on in America today. We were created as a nation of laws, not as a nation of men. And yet you heard from the president's own words that something he did not have the power to do under the Constitution, he decided to go ahead and do. Then in my 31st lawsuit against President Barack Obama was the lawsuit that put a stop to his illegal executive amnesty order. We've prevailed so far through the district court, through the court of appeals. Now he wants to take it to the Supreme Court,
right,
where I predict he will lose again.
Well, I hope so. I know that we all have our fingers crossed with the Supreme Court, but we've been disappointed by them before. Are you optimistic about that fight?
I am. And listen, I understand Americans have reason to be disappointed in the United States Supreme Court, because we now have a Supreme Court that no longer applies the law. We have a Supreme Court that rewrites the law. And so there is danger and concern about even our own United States Supreme Court. That said, this case is so clear because the Constitution is perfectly clear. It gives only to the Congress the power to write immigration laws.
Right.
The president himself is our best witness here, because he said, quote, he just rewrote the law. And he cannot do that.
No.
And so I believe the Supreme Court will agree with the lower courts and say the president was wrong to rewrite the immigration laws, granting amnesty to millions of people illegally.
And to remind our viewers, too, this, what he's asking to essentially be overturned here is the waiver of deportations for 5 million illegal aliens in the country. He wanted DACA, the Deferred Action Childhood Arrival extended, DAPA, Deferred Action for Parental Arrival extended. That's the big beacon that's drawing people to cross the border illegally in the first place.
And Dana, to be clear, what he's wanting to do, and this is one thing that really triggers the violation, he wants to provide affirmative benefits for those who are here knowingly illegally. And so it's going beyond just not engaging in prosecuting these people.
Right.
It's actually providing benefits to those who are knowingly here illegally. And that completely rewrites the immigration laws of this nation. That is a power the president does not have. It is time for the rule of law to be enforced in the United States of America. It is time for President Barack Obama to follow those laws also.
Yes, absolutely. And those benefits, too, by the way, those are provided by the taxpayers of that state They're the ones who provide it, and yet they're not getting a voice when the president comes in with his magic wand and undoes it all.
You're exactly right. Is the people of Texas who are picking up the cost of these benefits, as well as people of other states. And so we have these unfunded mandates coming from Washington, D.C., because they are not only not applying the law, but they are rewriting the laws illegally.
Right, absolutely. One of the things that I was reading the other day, Governor, to switch focus, keeping it Texas-centric, though, I read that all of the people coming into the state of Texas, you know, I came in 2 years ago from Missouri. So many people are moving into Texas. They love that there's no state income tax. They love, you know, the affordability of housing, the great schools. I've learned to love the highway system. I understand it now. But I've been reading that the majority of people coming in are from California. So I started to get a little nervous because we know how Californians tend to vote. And I know that you are looking to really shape the Republican primary conversation. You're really looking to get primary voters engaged. And I was wondering, how do you do that and work to keep Texas conservative and work to keep these primary voters engaged when we have a lot of people coming in from California, may not be so Republican primary-ish, Governor?
Well, Danny, let me at first put you at ease.
Okay.
Because during that campaign, when I ran against Wendy Davis,
yes.
We did polling.
And you won in a landslide.
I
don't want to interrupt
do.
You, but I feel like I have to say, and you won in a massive, massive landslide. Go ahead, Governor. I'm sorry.
Well, here's what we did. In addition to asking, are you going to vote for Greg Abbott or Wendy Davis? We also asked those demographic questions. What's your age range, your income range, your education range? We also asked, have you moved to Texas recently from another state? And if so, which state? And over 10% of the people who responded to the poll had come here from California. The good news, 2/3 of those people were voting for me. So the conservatives from California are the ones coming to Texas. If you are dependent on government, the last place you'll leave is California.
Right.
If you are dependent on government, the last place you will come to is the state of Texas. But to answer your question, what I am doing is, for example, I am setting as a litmus test for those running as Republicans in the state of Texas, they must support my position on cracking down on sanctuary cities.
Yes.
If you're going to vote for me and crack down on sanctuary cities, you should vote for that candidate. If you are against my sanctuary city crackdown plan, you should not vote for that person. And we have other issues that we are raising, such as my effort to reform ethics in the state of Texas. I believe that those who serve in the Texas legislature should not be casting votes where they line their own pockets.
Right.
They should not profiteer off of their position as legislators. And so it's going to be issues like this that I lay out over the next few weeks and few months, where I will be talking to the voters about who they should vote for, at least the types of issues they should be voting for when they cast their votes this March.
Well, you really put me at ease with that California statistic, because I was really sweating that. I have to tell you, I was really sweating that, Governor.
don't sweat it anymore. But Dana, I want you to know, I back the support of the Blaze hosting a meeting here in Texas so that we can have a real debate among real conservatives, with conservatives asking the questions.
And obviously we would see you there if we were to do this this primary debate. We would definitely see you there, Governor.
I would be there.
Absolutely. Texas Governor Greg Abbott, always good to see you, sir. Thank you so much. All right, coming
Thank
up,
you.
Developing new